Welcome back students once again to the accounting session. We were learning the chapter Fundamentals of Partnership. So in Fundamentals of Partnership, basically we have learned definition of partnership. Then we have learned features of partnership, meaning and contents of partnership deed, P&L appropriation account, guarantee of profit to a partner, interest on drawings, calculation of interest on drawings under product method, calculation of interest on drawings under shortcut method, calculation of interest on drawings if partners withdraw quarterly, both under product method and shortcut method. Today we are going to learn methods of maintaining capital accounts. So in case of sole trading concern, only one person will be investing and he will take the profit or loss of the business for himself only, because he is the risk taker and he only concerned to the profit or loss or interest on capital or drawings, whatever it is, concerned to the sole proprietor. But here two or more persons are coming together and forming a partnership firm. So here each and every partner's capital account should be maintained separately, because all the partners are supposed to know how much of capital they have invested in the partnership firm and how much of interest they are getting on their capitals, how much of salary they are getting or commission in case if they are supposed to get, and in case if there is any profit on P&L appropriation account, how much of share of profit they are going to get. In case of loss, how much loss they are supposed to sustain, and if they have made any drawings, how much amount will be deducted from their capital. These are all details they are supposed to know. So to know all these things, each and every partner's capital account should be maintained separately. So there are two methods for maintaining the capital accounts of the partners. First is fixed capital method. Under this method, the capital will never change. It remains fixed. Only in case if additional capital is brought by the partner, it will be added to the capital account. Or else, if the partner is withdrawing some amount permanently, it will be recorded in the capital account. Or else, nothing will be recorded other than the initial amount invested by the capital, invested by the partner as capital. So other items like share of profit or loss, interest on capital, salary, interest on drawings and drawings etc. are recorded in a separate account called as current account. So let us see the format of the fixed capital method. So here is the format of the fixed capital method. So we have taken one example of X and Y partners, and this is the capital account under the fixed capital method. So particulars X, Y, these are the two partners. Particulars X, Y, this is debit side and this is credit side. By balance brought down, it means whatever was the capital of the partner in the previous year, that will be transferred to this year. That is, the opening balance of capital is so much of last year. And in case if he has bought any fresh capital during the year, additional capital or fresh capital during the year, it will be added to the capital account. And in case if he has made any permanent drawings means he withdraws and he will never return it back to the firm. If such drawing is there, that amount should be debited to the partner's capital account, and whatever remains, that will be the partner's capital during the year. So this is the form of fixed capital method. And here we have not taken any adjustment as to interest on capital or salary or the profit or loss that we have arrived from the P&L appropriation account etc. So only we have considered what, how much was the capital, and in case if he has bought any additional capital, that should be added to the capital account of the partner. And then in case if he has made any permanent withdrawal of capital, that should be deducted from the his capital, and whatever balance remains, that will be the capital during the year or the for the year. So all the other adjustments are made in a separate account called as what, current account. in the current account what we do is, here in case if he is already maintaining the capital accounts under fixed capital method, the current account balances will be available. In case if it is a credit balance, it will be by balance brought down. In case if it is a debit balance, to balance brought down. You should show it on the debit side. And then by salary, in case if he is entitled to any salary, here in the example I have taken X is entitled to salary and Y is not entitled, so salary is not given to Y. And by commission, X is not entitled to commission, Y is entitled to commission, so commission is paid to Y. Interest on capital, it should be calculated as we have done in the P&L of proportion account. So after P&L of proportion account only, we will prepare what? Capital accounts. The data will be transferred from P&L of proportion account to capital accounts. So whatever is the interest on capital, that should be distributed to X and Y. And then P&L of proportion account, whatever is the profit, that should be distributed according to the profit sharing ratio. And then on the debit side, drawings, in case if he has done, if he has made drawings during the year, that will be debited to his capital account. Interest on drawings, it will be debited to his capital account. P&L of proportion account, in case if there is loss, it will be debited to the partner's capital account. So he will do the total of credit side and deduct debit side items, and whatever remains, that will be the balance. In case if debit balance is more and credit balance is less, the balance will be carried forward on the credit side. It means the current account is showing what? Deficit. Thank you.